One crisp winter morning, Boko awoke to find that Edward had not arrived back from the big station.
I've never known Edward be this late, he thought. He's usually so reliable.
The station master walked over. I've just had the flight controller on the phone, he said. Edward is unwell and has had to go to the works. I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to manage the branch trains alone for the time being. Control will send another engine up as soon as they can arrange it.
As soon as they can arrange it, indeed, huffed Boko. I can't handle all the trains by myself.
Why not mix the trains? Asked Henry. I've heard of something similar on the mainland before.
The passengers won't like it, sighed the driver. But you're right, Henry. It's the only real way to keep things going.
I'll make the arrangements, said the station master. And that's what he did.
Boko was kept busy all morning. Backwards and forwards he rumbled, up and down the branch with long, heavy trains. There was no time to rest at the stations. No sooner had he arrived than it was time to go again.
The passengers grumbled horribly. I say, what is that smell? My word, are we to be treated like coal trucks?
Well, it is Christmas.
Talking of Christmas, where am I going to sit? There aren't nearly enough coaches.
Poor Boko.
At the harbor, he stopped for a drink and a siding out of the way. He enjoyed the peace and quiet. A faint sea breeze blew into his face. He was just feeling a little better when...
Bill and Ben have arranged your goods train back, said the foreman. Off you go.
Boko's eyes goggled.
This is ridiculous. Whoever the Fat Controller sends had better arrive soon.
The driver was fed up too.
I haven't even had time to finish my sandwiches.
They found the trucks and set off back to Edward Station. Waiting on the turntable was Stanley.
Sorry I'm late, he panted. A faulty signal held me up on Thomas's branch. We couldn't go until it was fixed.
Of course, Boko couldn't be cross at this. He even managed a little smile. Stanley worked hard with the passengers, while Boko looked after the goods. By then, all of his trains were late, and he hurried frantically to make up the lost time. While Stanley worked hard, he couldn't keep pace.
Sorry, I'm late, said Stanley.
You're not late, Boko sighed. I'm early. The signal rose. See you later.
They reached the harbor where the goods train was waiting. Stanley arranged this for you, said the foreman.
Boko groaned. No wonder he was late. Where are Bill and Ben? That's what they should have been doing.
Come on, old lad, soothed the driver. The day's almost over, and there's not so much to take.
By then, Boko was feeling rather bitter. Boko's night's goods goes to the other railway. He was on the main line now, and had just crested Gordon's Hill when he started to go slower and slower.
Come on, come on, he growled furiously to his trucks, but it was no good. With a cough, he came to a stop.
The guard placed detonators and walked along the sleepers to the signal box, while Boko's driver looked his engine over.
I'm sorry, old boy, you've overheated. Quite a thing to happen in this weather, but not surprising given how hard you've been working.
Dark clouds above threatened snow. The once pleasant sea breeze was now icy and unwelcoming. and the driver huddled in the cab as the snow began to fall. At least there was Coco. Boko waited for a very long time. He felt so cold now his engine was off. His driver turned up his coat collar. Suddenly, they heard a bang. Then another.
"Hello there, Boko," said a genial voice.
It was Edward the Blue Engine, workman huddled in his tender. Boko was too cold and sad to reply. Workman made sure he was safe to move. Then Edward coupled up and pulled the train away. Henry met them at the next station to take the train to the other railway. Edward and Stanley helped Boko back to the yard.
"Oh, never mind," called Stanley. "You're sure to feel better after a good snooze in a nice cozy shed."
Boko sighed pathetically. He was soon ready for work again, trundling up and down the branch line. He was more lethargic, however, and it was lucky the Fat Controller decided to keep Stanley on for the Christmas period. As Edward passed through Harbour Yards, he noticed Boko looking very sorry for himself.
"I wish we could do something special for him. If only we could." "Yes, I'm sure of it. I'll ask the Fat Controller."
When Edward returned to the sheds that night, he told the Fat Controller his plan.
"I don't approve of having these, surprises so late in the day, Edward. However, old Boko deserves a treat for all his hard work."
And he strode thoughtfully away to make the arrangements. Christmas Eve dawned, the fields twinkled with morning frost, and Boko set out with his morning goods as usual. Edward and the twin set to work at once.
"He's going to love it," squeaked Bill as he passed through some trucks.
He and Ben were usually locked up in their sheds at the clay pits on Christmas.
"Well, we can only hope he does," Edward wheezed nervously.
Some lawyers came into the yard, and the Fat Controller stepped down. Boko was tired as he sidled home that night. All the while, he could only stare down at his buffers.
"At least the bulk of the work is done now," he said quietly to his driver. "And," he went on, "tomorrow is Christmas."
"Hush! Hush a moment," said his driver. "Can you hear something?"
Boko slowed and quieted his engine.
He could hear singing. As he approached the yard, it got louder and louder. He could make out colorful flashing lights between the rows of trucks. "Here he is," called Stanley. The yard was filled with the sound of whistling and cheering, and Boko gave a hoot of alarm himself. He gazed around to see the yard and station had been festooned with decorations, along with a large, brightly lit Christmas tree. "Well, I never did," exclaimed his driver.
Boko was speechless too, smiling for the first time in a fortnight. The Fat Controller stepped forward.
"I've heard you've been working very hard as of late, Boko, and that short of work does not go unappreciated."
"Well, sir, I'm honored, but this really isn't my sort of thing."
"Yes, I know that," the Fat Controller said kindly. "And so I'm sending you to the works."
"But sir," faltered Boko, "I feel just fine, if not a little tired, sir."
"I know that as well. Every Christmas I host a big lunch at the works for all the railway staff and their families to celebrate a hard year's work. The workshops are usually full of tables and chairs, admittedly, but I'm sure we can make room for you next to my buffet. What do you think of that?
Well, sir...
Hip hip! Started Bill.
Hooray!
Shrieked Ben, and soon the cheer echoed around the yard.
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
Everyone cheered.
I'll take that as a yes, grinned the Fat Controller.
Soon the party was in full swing.
Thank you for the party, and thank you for giving me a rest this year, Boko sighed. I'll enjoy the peace and quiet.
Edward smiled knowingly.
You're most welcome. Merry Christmas, old friend.
By then, Boko was feeling rather bitter. When Edward returned to the sheds that night, he told the Fat Controller his plan. He gazed around the yard to see that the yard and... Some lawyers came into the yard, and the Fat Controller stepped down. And does nothing.
I don't approve of having these, surprises so late in the day, Edward.
Bit cockney. Gotta think bacon sandwiches.
I don't approve of having these, surprises.
Still cockney. Let me try something.
Ooh, bacon sandwiches, yes. I'll eat your bacon sandwiches with my fist. I'll shove them in my mouth.
If this is a blooper reel, you can have it.